G'day, this is Michael. Got a bit of a coin search. So, looking forward to this. Yeah, jumping in. Got a couple of 5 cent rolls, a couple of $1 rolls, and a 50 and a 20. So, let's start with a 5 cent roll. We'll go there and get the echidna, nice little echidna, and Queen Elizabeth. And we'll go through all of those coins and see what we can find. Hopefully, you've been having a great day. Here we go. Just searched a roll of $1 coins on a off camera or on a video, and found a couple of errors. So that's pretty cool. Rabbit ears error, and another one that I hadn't really seen before. So that's pretty cool. I like that. Okay, 5 cent coins. Whoops. Looking for the flamingo on there, but not a flamingo, that one. G'day, Nike Man, how's it going? Good luck, Hans. Thank you, appreciate that. So keen for them notes. That's right. They're sitting over here. So I'll show you actually. So I'll just zoom out, and I'll grab those notes and show you. So they're in this. They're all together in this thing. So I won't take them out. But they're all the $5 notes in perfect condition and pretty cool serial number too. Like 660561. So a few sixes in there. And yeah, is it 12? I can't remember. It's a 12 notes, yeah, 12 consecutive 1985 banknotes. I'm just being careful with them. These little holders that I've got it in, they're quite a good quality holders, pretty firm and rigid and stuff like that. So we don't get any bends, but they're perfect $5 notes. 12 consecutive serial number, perfect condition. All yours, Corey. All right, I'll just put those back over there. Keep them in a safe space for you. Send them out. So for those that are wondering, yeah, Corey's snagged those $5 notes and gonna get them sent out soon. Yeah, so keen. Nice. G'day, Dave. How's it going? But it is nice having some of those paper notes just in perfect condition because quite easy to crease and so on. Having them in just perfect condition is pretty special, and having 12 consecutive as well. That's cool as well. Ooh, dropped one. Oh no, I dropped 5 cents. VB man, thank you for the little gift. Nice. 2005, check for the flamingos. I found a 1972 last week, which was cool. They're pretty hard to find, the 1972 5 cent coins, and definitely worth holding on to. Welcome, thank you. 2005, no flamingo on that one, so we will continue on with a different roll. Dave says, just thinking about selling your coin collection. Okay, yep, nice one, nice. Yep, everyone gets to a point, or for what different reasons you might sort of look at selling and stuff like that. So yeah, Wes says you got five of them. Is that the 1972 5 cent coin? Yeah, nice. Or is it the flamingos? Wes, I'm not too sure. All right, some 20s, 20 cent coins. We'll get in a bit tighter on these ones, and then we can check for details that we might want to look for. So these ones can be a little bit rotated. Give this one a twirl. Not rotated there. Oh, keep on going. Got no idea. Yeah, it can be a bit tricky because with coins, like individual coins, there can be a huge variance in what they can sell for based on the condition. So individual coins, it just depends on the condition of each individual coin, the values and so on. David McRae says, how much did I miss? Any fines? This is just the second roll. So far, I've just put aside this. What have I put aside this 5 cent coin? Oh, it's a 1994 5 cent coin, this one. And I need to check it under a digital microscope for a large SD. So that's the only one I've put aside so far. So down here, there's a little SD. And it stands for Stuart Devlin, the designer of this side of the coin. But you need to see the specific detail of that SD to see if it's a large one, which is worth holding on to. Samil, I have a lot of $2 coins if you want to buy off me. Oh, thanks for the offer. But yeah, I tend to like to try and find the coins I'm looking for. I'd appreciate the offer there, yeah. $2001, we'll check for a rotation. There we go. Nice. Oh, so similar. If you got a red poppy from 2012, that's a quite a rare $2 coin. That's one I haven't got at this stage, but maybe one day. Maybe one day. All right, we'll do a $1 roll now. So I got the Australian $1 coins, the mob of roos on here. Someone says in the chat, Coin Australia to whom 1993 $1 coin. The 1993 is a bit of a high mintage $1 coin. Yeah. You got 2012 red poppies. Man, that is some good going. Did you find them in circulation or? Gee. Wow, that's unbelievable. Nice going. Stony Timber, how long have you been doing this? About 5 or 6 years. About 5 or 6 years, yeah. Name a car for an edit. Oh, Ferrari. Ferrari. Yeah, you got lucky. That's nice, Samuel. That's very good. Very good. $1 coins. Oh, let's see if we can find a mule $1 coin that's worth a fair amount of money. So there's that 1993 coin. Yeah, high mintage coin. Some of these can have a C mint mark down here. This one's very worn. You can get a little C mint mark, I think, down there. And you can also get a bit of extra metal through the grooves up here. That's a bit of a minting error. So keep an eye out for those. Ollie, how's it going, Ollie? Whoops. Oh, I was trying to turn that corner, but it didn't work out. Oh, well, onward. Name an AFL player for an edit. Steel side bottom. Check for rotations right there. Oh, I appreciate the gift there. Thanks, Big Willy Will. How's it going? Snagged any cool ones recently? Actually, I just did a roll before and I'll put the video on my stream at some stage, but I found this rabbit ears, which is cool. That extra blob of metal on the back there. But this second coin, and this one also, the rabbit ears also has got a little chunk of metal over here on the side of the coin too, so I haven't seen that before or noticed that. I initially just thought damage, but it sort of looks like it's maybe a bit of a chunk of metal. But this one here, it's got like a little ribbon coming off the top of that top kangaroo. Interesting, interesting. Cool. Bit of an error. Dino, how's it going? Good. No complaints. Nothing to write home about. Yeah. Yeah, it's be a little bit hard to find stuff, but the search is still on. Still on. 50 cent coins. Let's go. See if I can snag a 1993 or a 1985 50 cent coin. Yeah, they're good low mintage dates on the 50 cent coins to find. Ooh, look for the enqueued flag. That one's not enqueued. Jenna, you're my favorite person on TikTok. Oh, thanks, Jenna. It's a kind thing to say. Appreciate that. All right, 2010 50 cent coin. Hold it at the top and the bottom, and then give a little twirl around. And the coin can sometimes be rotated on the 2010s. I've never found a 50 cent rotation, one of these, but people do. And I'll keep on searching for them. If I find a 2010, I'll keep searching. All right, let's get a bit more zoom in here. About halfway through this roll right here. Oh, thanks, Belinda. Thanks for the gift there. Ooh, look for that enqueued flag. Not there, not there. G'day, Belinda. Yeah. The 72s, 73s, and 74s are lower mintage, worth holding on to. This one's a bit of a high mintage coin there. Yeah, Prince Charles and Lady Diana coin. I've got a fair few in really nice condition, so I don't need to hold on to too many more. All right, so that's the 50 cent roll. What do you want to see? Would you prefer to see the 5 cent roll next or the $1 roll next? Let me know in the chat. We can go there. Nike Man loves the Lady Di coin. Nice, nice. Ooh, one of each. Tino says $1. Charlie says 5 cents. $1, one. Leave the $1 for last. Okay, we're getting torn around a little bit here. 5 cent, 5 cent. Oh, if we get another 5 cent, it's like three in a row. Maybe we'll go with that. It's probably not enough people watching to get another taker. Oh, $1. Belinda says $1. Oh, a couple of $1. Oh, another. Okay, there's four $1. Nominees in a row, so we'll do the $1 roll, then we'll do the 5 cents, so it won't take long. Thanks for letting me know, guys. Sorry if I couldn't satisfy your request. A few slightly shinier coins there. Let's see what we got there. Fairly evenly split there, weren't we? 2006, just a bit shinier. Oh, there we go. The lowest mintage of the Anzac coins are 2015 Anzac. So some prices on these between... I've got to find it on my list first. That's where we're at. Oh, there we are. $4 to $10. 1.4 million. Only 1.4 million of that coin minted, so that's pretty cool. Nightman says, great Aussie coin hunt coins in my guess. Yeah, those sometimes are a bit shinier, aren't they? Yeah, because they're fairly recent. That one was looking pretty shiny. Okay, about halfway through. So we've got one of the $1 coins put aside. That Anzac is aside. Let's see if there's something else. You know, is that like a bit of a spew roo? It's probably a bit of dirt. Yeah, just a bit of dirt there. Now, guess the year. We'll do a guess the year on this one. So the Anzac coins, there's five different years this could be. 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, or 2018. Have a guess in the chat. Okay, we've got a 14, 14, 15, 16, 14, 18. Nice, nice. Yeah, most likely going to be a 2014 because they made a lot that year. They made 22 million in 2014 and not that many in the other years. So, however, I'm going to be a little risque. I'm going to go for one of those years that's not a 2014. I'm going to go 2018. That's where my guess is at. We'll see who's correct, though. We'll flip it over in a couple of seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go, boom. Oh, 2014. All those people in the chat who guessed 2014 correct. Good stuff. Okay, so that's the $1 roll done. So, yeah, we did have an Anzac. Ooh. Oh, my screen has done something, but anyway. So we got an Anzac coin right there from 2015, I found, early on in that roll. So that is a keeper. Last roll from today's little search. We've done 1 5-cent roll. And this is the second. Oh, no. Just accidentally dropped a few 5-cent coins. I'll pick a few of them up. There we go. Put them on the top. Keep dropping out the side of my other hand. That's all right. I'll grab it. It's 2005. It could be a flamingo. No, it's not a flamingo. It's a fairly old coin. And he started minting 5-cent coins in 1966, so I was only a couple of years off that. 67, the second year of 5-cent coins. Another 67. Let's check for the flamingo. The flamingo, for those who are wondering, it's a bit of extra metal coming off the bottom of the five. Looks like a flamingo's beak. I do have one on my desk. I'll just get it for you to show. So there's one there. Got that extra bit of metal through there. It looks a bit like a flamingo's beak, like it's a flamingo's head, and that's its beak. So a recent selling price range on these on a 2001, $30 to $60. So there you go. Worth having a quick look to see if it's one of those. Ooh, here we go, flamingo. No. A couple of coins to go. 76, 88, and year 2000, the new millennium. So I've got a 1994 here that I need to check under a digital microscope to see if that's a large SD down there. So I need to check that. Should I do it now? Who wants to see it? I might flick on the digital microscope. Oops, and then I can show you and we can have a look together. All right. Just turning it on, get it in position. All right, and I'll show you with the camera to zoom out. So this is my digital microscope right here. So I've got the coin down there and you can see here that SD, unfortunately, it's not the large SD that you need to look for. With the large SD, the S is really upright. It's really up and down, straight up and down. So yeah, that's not the one I'm looking for, unfortunately. But some prices on those 1994s, $3.90 to $6. So not a huge markup, but sometimes they can be worth a bit more than that, those large SDs. So it's worth checking. What else have we got? And we've got the Anzac coin from 2015. So that's the one I've put aside from this little search. Yeah, all right, do it. Someone in the chat wants to. Yeah, but if you've got any more questions before I head off, ask away, because pretty much done that little search. There's all the coins in here. So all these coins go in the bag, and then I take that bag back to the bank and put it through the coin deposit machine all in one go. So I usually keep the coins until I've got a fair few. I've got a few bags down here full of coins down there. And then I just take them back to the bank on a particular day. And then, yeah, drop them all off and then get some more coins to be searching. So try and find some and stack them on my desk like that. Let's see if there's any more questions people might have. No, I think everyone's good. Everyone's good. All right. I hope you all have a great day and good luck with your searches. If you're searching for things, hopefully you find some cool things that you can put into your collection. And yeah, have a great one. Oh, here's a question come through. Blue Ute says, how are you going to take money out from the banks? I just walk up to the counter and say, hi, can I please have $1,000 in coins? And they said, yeah, how would you like that? And then I just tell them how I'd like it. That's how I do it. Someone says, wait, Belinda, you too. Thanks, Belinda. How much is the 5 golden mint? I'm not sure what that coin is. Sorry. Yeah. Blue Ute says they're not allowing cash extracts anymore. Oh, no, the bank I go to does. I know the Commonwealth Bank have restricted people, so they need to have business accounts to use the coin roll dispensing machine. But I think you can still get $100 worth of coins out. Yeah, that's just the Commonwealth Bank. Every other bank that I know of is still, you can still get coins out. Oh, here a few more questions come through. Here we go. Have a great day. What coin do you look for in the 10-cent coin? Oh, there's a fair few coins. So I've got my coin list on the wall there. So I've got a fair few 10-cent coins. That's the 10-cent list. That's the 5-cent list, 20-cent, and so on. But oh, some good 10-cent coins, 1985 and 2011. 1985, 2011, so check that out. What's the most valuable coin an ordinary person might come across in their day-to-day life? Maybe a wavy baseline 20-cent coin can be worth up to 5,500 in perfect condition. But if you're finding it in circulation, it's probably going to be probably more around that $200 to $400 sort of price range. Also, the $1 mule coin, they can generally be worth similar sort of range, I suppose, in worn condition, that $200 to $400, $500 sort of range too. Yeah. Oh, a fair few questions coming through. What's your favorite coin? Oh, one of my favorite coins is this one here, my 2 pence coin from 1797. That's one of my favorite coins. Yeah. Sleeve says, do you stack your coins on your desk in a specific order? No, I haven't really. No. There seems to be a fair few goldish ones over that way, and then the 50s over the back, but there's no really rhyme to it. It just sort of started off me just putting some of the coins. I'd search through coins and I'd just put them on my desk so I can sort of see them and just pile them up. And it's just sort of grown into a little city of towers, like a city, I suppose, yeah. Hey, Specky, how's it going? I'm going well, thanks. Yeah, hopefully you're going well too. G'day, Casey. Are you late? Yeah, I'm just finishing up, actually. I was just about to go, and then people started asking questions, so I'm just going through and answering some questions. Hunter says, how much is your collection worth? Oh, I've got no idea. Yeah, sorry, no, I'm not too sure. Mark, g'day, Mark. How's it going? Yeah. G'day, Nervan. How's it going? Yeah, but, cool. All right, then I might sort of leave it there. So, hope you all have a great day or great night wherever you are. And good luck with your searches. Hopefully, you find some cool coins and have a good one. All right, we'll catch you later. See ya.